Welcome to Kusum.net. This is JavaScript tutorial and you are watching part 7, while loop in JavaScript. So let's see how to do this. We have seen in the last lecture that how to use the for loop, and inside of for loop we need the initialization, the condition and the increment or decrement value, right? So now today we will see what is the difference between while loop and for loop. This while loop required, if you know the iterations, number of iterations, then you have to use for loop, okay? But when some conditions, if you don't know about iterations, how many iterations will be, that time you will use while loop. Means if you don't know how many rows you have to display, that time you have to use while loop. So let's see and what is the condition for that, right? So let's remove these all things and check it. I am going to create while loop. For that, what you need, you need the while keyword and this small brackets and the curly brackets. Inside of this you have to write the conditions, okay? Like that, document dot write document dot write line, and inside of that you will pass the message what you want, okay? Suppose you want x, okay, that you have to pass. And if I want this in h1 tag, then you will provide it h1 plus x, then plus h1 completed. So you have to write here, okay, like this. So this is the completion of the while loop format. Now inside of while keyword you have to write the limitation, means up to how many rows you want to display, because you don't know the iterations or how many iterations you have to display. So you will write, suppose I have to display 1 to 10 numbers, okay? So you have the limitation, suppose x less than 10. So you have to write like this, x less than 10, and you have to declare the variable for x. So variable x equal to suppose 1. So starting from 1 and up to the 10th row, you have to display this message of the x, okay? Now here is only this condition, x is less than 10, but in for loop there is initialization, condition, increment or decrement, okay? So all need all these three things. Here is this initialization of the x variable, the condition of the x variable, but there is no increment or decrement. So you have to write here the increment or decrement value inside of this. But if I don't write that, then what happened? Let's see. So I am saving this and write the path about this. What is this file name? Let's see. So this is my file, switch case, okay. Copy path and write in the browser, paste it here, okay. Run the program, press F5, Control V. This is going in the infinite loop. Why? Because we have not given the increment or decrement value. So let's give the increment or decrement value, like x equal to x plus 1 or 2 maybe, okay, and whatever you want. So if I pass this increment or decrement value and save this program and run in the browser, that time it will run the program exactly. Because we have not passing the increment or decrement value, the loop is gone inside of the infinite, okay? So let's refresh this, and you can see here the values are now coming. If I pass here x plus 2, then 1, 3, 5 means every value have a two numbers difference. Okay, so this type you can pass this increment or decrement value inside of this. and your condition will be here and initialization of here. So all these three steps required in every time, but for for condition you have all the three things: initialization, condition and increment or decrement, all inside of that for loop. But here there is different way, and this while loop is used when you don't know the iterations or row numbers, how many rows you want to display. But in for loop you know how many iterations you have to display, so there is the another steps. Okay, so this is the end of this tutorial. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel, like it, share it. Thank you. Have a great day.